Okay, this video is about how we're going to create elevations. So this one's already pretty well done. I'm just going to kind of move it over for a second and not save this. What I want to be able to do is show you that what we're doing is we xref in the arc base floor plan layers. Actually, I'm going to undo that. I'm going to put it back where it is. Okay, and you want your world coordinate system to be with the square down here in the corner on the XY, so you know you're rotated correctly. And then you will bring in the floor plans for as many layers of floors as you have and insert those. Being on layer 0, set them down at 0, 0. They all stack on top of each other per floor. Okay, and then the next thing you would do, and then now I will just kind of copy move this over so I can talk about how I got here. Just move it 500 feet just so I know that it's out of the way, but I know how to put it back. Okay, so in this scenario, what I would do if I had no elevations yet is I would start by drawing a box on layer A elev floor line. Okay, and then based on what our design decisions are for floor to floor height, I will offset that line. So I might offset it 9 feet from the basement ceiling, offset it 12 inches to get to the next floor, offset it 9 feet to get to the next top of plate, or let's say maybe the second floor is only 8 feet to top of plate. Okay, and the reason I do that is because I'm going to draw around the house. So let's say that I wanted to first only be drawing not the second floor of the three floors I have stacked, so I'm going to unload that one. And let's say I want to start by drawing the basement, so I'm going to reload that one, or you know, make it visible. Okay, I have forced all the colors to be a color because I've got stacked floors, so I may have put the basement layers all on 131 color, and then the next floor on 151 color, and the next floor on 181 color, just so I can see them all. But with that, then what I want to do is go to the ALF guideline layer. Okay, and I want to just start picking up things like edge of slab, edges of column, and edges of the wall. Okay, the garage door frame. Okay, and when I've done that, then I can stretch all these down below the basement floor line. And I can just copy one. Make sure you hit your endpoint. Okay, and copy it to the other frame. Remind yourself there's a column in the wall, or that we've got a furring on a column. Next garage door frame. Okay. This is the idea for windows too, up above. And then a column in the wall, and then the thickness of the wall, and then the thickness of the concrete wall. Okay, because then what you'll see you're capable of is drawing on these layers, which should be things like ALF medium one, that's ALF hatch, I forced it to be red because it's in the foreground, ALF medium one, ALF heavy one, ALF hatch is what that layer is. So, okay, now you can see you start designing the trim around the windows and things like that. The guidelines I just showed you will inform, if I were to copy all of that and this floor line, if I can grab it, maybe it's on a locked layer, I can't quite tell. If I move all that, the 500 feet that I'd offset it, just to make the point, you will see, okay, that things start to line up, like the door frame, like the columns, right? There's those lines of the interior columns. If I type region and I erase those once I'm done, okay, then you can see the column lines are in there. Okay, so that's what that starts to inform, is what you're going to draw an elevation. When you're done with that floor, then you could go XREF, turn off the basement by unload, turn on the next floor by reload. Okay, and you'll see things like, okay, the column posts are lining up, right? And then you're gonna, you could erase the ones that don't line up anymore that you don't need from the basement, but then you could go down and copy this one for, you know, all the columns on the second floor and the window frames. We'll design the height of those. If they're not already noted somewhere in floor plans, we'll start thinking about window heights, not just locations. Okay, so same concept. You're going through and picking up all the elevation lines that matter, right? And that way, when you bring over, none of this would have been drawn yet, but if I brought this all back over 500 feet, then you'll notice that as we drew these, okay, there's your windows on a, you know, the outside edge is the edge of ref opening, which is what we dimension. That lines up perfectly here. The inside line isn't perfect, but that's okay. That might have just been a design style choice I made after the size of the window frame and plan. Ref opening is what really matters. But again, you see that these are lining up with the columns, lining up with the windows. So that's how we did that. And then in elevation, I'm designing how high is the wainscot, or the brick base versus the shingles above. Are we having corner boards? Okay, things like that. And then you would do that on all four sides. So then what you end up doing is just typing UCS, enter, for around the Z coordinate, type 90, and you see down here that your UCS rotated 90 degrees to the left. And then if you type plan, enter, to the current UCS, enter, it rotates you to the next place where you want to pull down those guidelines. Okay, so then you keep rotating the UCS and get yourself all the way around the drawing. So that's how we set it up. The reason I like drawing around it is because if you change any elevation height, it's changing on all four facades. And then I can teach you how to rotate viewports in a different training, which is applicable when we're not in the base elevation file where we do our line work only, but when we are actually in a sheet file like A31, A32, and then we'll deal with the rotation stuff as it relates to dimensions, etc.